Oh, hey, I didn't see you there. I'm just going on random websites until I find an ad that wins me a lottery. Looks like I got one. Name, Alex. Social security number. Easy. 1, 2, 3, 4. Please submit a 7 to 10 minute documentary on Edgar Wright. So let's talk about. As I was saying, let's talk about Edgar Wright. Wright's name might not jump out at you from the first time you hear it, so let me give you a few recognizable names. Hot Fuzz, Baby Driver, Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. Wright is one of the most skilled and influential filmmakers working in the industry today, and this story is one of his great accomplishments. April 18, 1974, Edgar Howard Wright was born. Along with his parents, Chris and Leslie, and his brother Oscar, Edgar grew up in Poole, England, in a traditional English family. However, from a young age, he showed many cases of his filmmaking gifts. Throughout his childhood, Edgar would constantly create, shoot, and direct his own personal movies. His prodigal abilities in the area were proven after winning a short film competition hosted by the television program Going Live.
Week's video maker is no stranger to making videos or to Saturday morning TV, Edgar Wright, with his partner in crime, Martin Curtis. Hi.
Following his passion for creating films and cinematic stories, Edgar would apply to multiple film schools in hopes of starting his directorial path. Unfortunately, that didn't work out as well as he would have hoped. Edgar would be rejected by every film school he applied to. Wright would eventually attend Bournemouth and Poole College of Art and earn a degree in audiovisual design. In 1995, Edgar would write and direct his first feature-length film, A Fistful of Fingers. After completing the film, Wright would soon meet a career-long partner and friend, Simon Pegg, from working on the short television miniseries, Asylum. After working on Asylum, Pegg would invite Wright to direct a new show called Space for British TV4. Working on Space would create one of the greatest trilogies in all of cinema, that of Wright, Pegg, and friend Nick Frost. The three would create what would become the Cornetto Trilogy, a trilogy of movies each starring Simon Pegg and Nick Frost, and each being directed by Edgar Wright. The first of these films to be finished was Shaun of the Dead, a comedic zombie flick in which all of England has been overrun with a virus, turning people into zombies. After Shaun of the Dead's success, Wright would soon team up again with Pegg and Frost to shoot the 2007 film Hot Fuzz. Hot Fuzz was a typical buddy cop film, which, as the story progressed, revealed the malevolent intentions of the characters living within its setting.
Deal with it.
Yeah, mother.
After finishing Hot Fuzz, Wright took a break from the Cornetto. He would soon be contacted by Universal Studios and producer Mark Platt to direct the film adaptation of the comic Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. Grounded in a loose reality somewhat like our own, Scott Pilgrim would allow for Wright to truly expand his creative filmmaking skills. Scott Pilgrim was that of a hyper-stylized rock opera based off of comic writer Brian Lee O'Malley's graphic novel. As Wright's first work since Shaun of the Dead not to feature either Simon Pegg or Nick Frost, the title character is played by Michael Cera, who was known at the time from films such as Superbad and Juno. Wright's filmmaking turned Michael Cera from a scrawny, awkward typecast into a true action hero. After Scott Pilgrim was met with great critical acclaim, Edgar Wright would return to partner Simon Pegg and Nick Frost to finish out the Cornetto trilogy. Edgar's swan song of the trilogy would be the 2013 film The World's End. The World's End tells the story of a group of friends who attempt to finish a bar crawl of all the bars within their hometown, including the aptly named The World's End. Unfortunately for Wright, despite grossing double its budget at the box office, Wright's trilogy-ending film would not be as critically well-received as his previous two in the trilogy. Luckily, this wouldn't be the end of Wright's filmmaking career, as we've seen with his next film released.
Thank you.
baby.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Right now, I got to tell you about the fabulous, most groovy Bell Bottom. Bell Bottom.
Baby, played by Ansel Elgort, is the titular getaway driver who suffers from tinnitus after suffering a car accident that killed both of his parents when he was young. Baby attempts to combat his condition when he drives by listening to music to drown out the ringing in his ears, while also allowing him to pull off amazing driving feats. Wright's use of audio within the film is truly a testament of his mastership of cinema, as well as a nod to his degree in audiovisual design from Bournemouth. Not simply having fitting music in each scene, but having each scene shot and acted out with specific music in mind. Actions in the film are performed in time with the music. Steps match up with the beats. Even most gunshots in the film are lined up with the music. Wright has always shown an aptitude for combining both music and action in films, such as in Shaun of the Dead, when the group beats a zombie with pool cues to the beat of Don't Stop Me Now by Queen. Or in the battle scenes of Scott Pilgrim vs. the World, which are all lined up with the music being sung. Baby Driver and Edgar Wright's use of music in film truly shows the importance of not simply using the music to fill out the scene, but to use it as another level to tell a story. That was a hefty 7 to 10 minutes. Oh. It wasn't supposed to be a documentary about Edgar Wright. It was supposed to be 7 to 10 digits of my credit card number.